Welcome to the channel. Today we're going to be looking at the SMLight SLZB-MR1, which is what's known as a multi-radio coordinator. It acts like a central traffic controller for your smart devices. So dependent upon which firmware you load onto your radio, it can handle Zigbee communications, be that ZHA or Zigbee2MQTT, or with a quick flash of the firmware, you can be running a Zigbee router or even a Thread border router. The configurations are totally up to you. Having two radios in a single device means you get to keep your existing ZHA network running smoothly while having your Zigbee2MQTT network or Thread and Matter without having to juggle extra hubs or dongles. So is the MR1 the answer to all your prayers, combining the stability of the old with the new protocol on the block, an all-in-one powerful coordinator? Let's jump on in and find out. When you take the SLZB-MR1 out of the box, it's immediately obvious that this isn't your average USB stick coordinator. It's a small but solid enclosure and about 16 centimeters long with two chunky external SMA antennas, one dedicated for each radio. Now they're not there just to look good either. Each one has a 5 dB gain and the radios themselves use a 20 dB power amplifier, which means you should see a noticeable boost in your range compared to a typical dongle. The case feels sturdy and is designed to be installed however you like. It can sit flat on your desk, mount on a wall, or clip into a DIN rail in your electrical cabinet for easy and clean installs. Around the side, you've got a USB-C port that can be used for power or connectivity, an Ethernet port with full PoE support and LEDs to signify the connectivity and speed, and a physical reset button on the top for those emergencies. And as you can imagine, with so much going on in this unit, there is ample ventilation to keep everything cool and performing at maximum efficiency. Inside, things get more interesting. The SLZB-MR1 has two separate radio chips and a Texas Instruments CC2652P7 and a Silicon Labs EFR32MG21. These are both highly respected for their stability and range, and because they're completely separate, there's no resource sharing between them. Everything runs on an ESP32 microchip with an SMLight custom SLZB OS firmware that gives you a built-in web interface for configuration and updates. One of the nicest things about the SLZB-MR1 is how flexible it is when it comes to connectivity. You can connect it over USB directly to your Home Assistant, run it as an Ethernet for a wired setup, or run it on Wi-Fi if running on a cable isn't convenient. As mentioned, for power, you can use a USB-C or take advantage of the built-in 802.3AF PoE support, which means you can power it and connect it to your network with a single cable. Power consumption is tiny at about 1.5 watts, so it's super efficient. Normally, I would connect my coordinator direct to my Home Assistant instance through a USB-C. This gives the lowest possible latency and can power the unit directly. However, I'll try something different. I've created a fresh installation of Home Assistant and plugged the MR1 into a USB power supply and plugged the LAN into my router. First, let's see the configuration on the MR1. Now you can spend time looking for your MR1 in the list of devices connected to your router, but a much simpler method is just to open a browser and navigate to http://slzb-mr1.local. This brings up the main dashboard for the MR1. And here you can see the IP address in the Ethernet section. Make a note of this as we'll need it later on. First, we should check the firmware of the device to make sure it's running the latest and greatest. SMLight, the manufacturer of the MR1, are constantly evolving these firmwares and adding new features. So running the latest gives you the best possibility of taking advantage of those new features. Navigate to the settings and tools in the left-hand menu. Select firmware updates. In the SLZB OS OTA update section, select check for updates. This will bring up all of the available updates for your device. Select the latest version, which is not dev build. In this case, I've already updated mine. It should be noted that sometimes you need to do this several times as you cannot jump to the latest version and it needs to run through intermediate versions first. so repeat this exercise until you're running the latest version. Once installed, the change log will be displayed and the device will reboot ready for use. This is also the place when you can check the firmware for Radio 1 and Radio 2 with whatever configuration you want to load. By default, these are Zigbee coordinators. Next, in the left-hand menu, press Mode. You can now configure Radio 1 for a Zigbee coordinator, a Zigbee router, and a matter over thread, all of which are one press installs for the appropriate firmware. On Matter 2, you get the same options for Zigbee coordinator, router, matter over thread, but you get an extra option for a Zigbee hub. I've never used this before, and says with this mode, you can pair, monitor, and control Zigbee end devices, sensors, switches, directly from the coordinator's web interface or via a built-in scripting language. No external tools like Zigbee2MQTT or ZHA is needed. You can also view device statuses and control in the coordinator Zigbee hub menu. There is a verified list of tested devices here, and a hyperlink to the list of supported devices is listed. If you've used this mode before, then please let us know your thoughts in the comments. For the vast majority of you, I would suggest that you're going to be using this as a Zigbee Home Automation Coordinator, or ZHA as it's known, and also as a Zigbee2MQTT coordinator running on one device. But likewise, you can also just run matter over thread and a Zigbee coordinator, and I'm planning on covering this in a separate video. The MR1 already shows that the Zigbee coordinator is loaded for both radios. However, if you want to make sure that it's loaded with the latest version and haven't done the firmware upgrade, then simply press the toggle for the Radio 1 Zigbee coordinator. The software will state it's going to reflash the firmware. Press Next, and confirm by pressing Change Mode to Zigbee Coordinator. The installation takes about a minute. Once finished, press Close. Now repeat the exercise for the other radio. And finally, before you move away from the MR1, let's press the Z2M and the ZHA in the left-hand menu. We'll set up a ZHA on Radio 1, and so we'll set the ZHA on the EFR32 SoC radio, and Zigbee2MQTT on Radio 2, which is the CC2652P7 chipset. Now let's open Home Assistant. Let's first set up the ZHA Automation, or ZHA as it's called. Navigate to Settings, Devices and Services. Select Add Integration in the bottom right-hand corner. Search for and select Zigbee Home Automation. Select Enter manually and press Submit, followed by ESZP as per the instructions for the MR1 configuration advice, and press Submit. Switch back to your MR1, and specifically to the Z2M and ZHA configuration menu. Make sure Radio 1 has selected ZHA. Now copy the line that says Sockets. Move back to Home Assistant, and paste this into the serial device path, and press Submit. Next, we can set network settings. As this is a new network, we should choose Erase Network Settings and create a new network. Alternatively, if you're migrating from a previous different Zigbee coordinator, you might wish to restore a backup. Now rename your device if needed and allocate to an area and press Skip and Finish. And your ZHA is now ready to go on Radio 1. Now there have been many reports of both radio devices getting added at the same time. But as long as you followed the instructions above and updated the core and Zigbee firmware to the latest, this should not happen to you. You can now add Zigbee devices to your ZHA as you normally would. Next, we'll configure Zigbee2MQTT. This will be the most usual configuration that most people will deploy. But remember, you can also set up the MR1 as a Zigbee router for extended range or even a thread border router. Let me know in the comments if you'd like to see that video. We'll be setting up Zigbee2MQTT from scratch on a fresh installation, so you don't need to look at any of my other videos. But if you've already done this, then you can skip ahead using the chapter markers below. Press Settings, followed by Add-ons, followed by Add-on Store. Search for and select Mosquito Broker. The Mosquito Broker is a server that uses the MQTT protocol. In other words, it acts as a bridge between Home Assistant and MQTT. Now press Install. This will take a little time. Be patient. Now before you can start the Mosquito Broker, you'll need to do a bit of configuration in it. Press Configuration in the top menu, For logins, as we'll be using a third-party add-in, we'll need to use one. If you watch my previous videos on this, I inserted a lot more security about this. Video in the pop-up above. But for this example, I'll use the username is MQTT and the password is also MQTT. Copy on screen or in the description below. Now scroll down and press the save button. Make sure that this is the save button for the section that you're updating. The save button will grey out if it is saved successfully. Now navigate to the info tab on the top menu. Turn on Watchdog, which will restart the add-on if it crashes for whatever reason. Now you can start the add-on by pressing the start button. Check that the add-on is running by looking in the log file and making sure that you can only see white and green text and no red. That would signify that there was an issue. Next, we'll need to add the Zigbee to MQTT. Navigate to Settings, Add-ons. Press the add-on store in the bottom right-hand corner. Zigbee to MQTT does not appear as standard, so you'll need to add it. Press the three dots in the top right-hand corner. Select Repositories. Now either copy and paste the link from the description or navigate to the address and copy the URL and paste it into the add field on the screen. Now press plus add. You can now see that the repository has been added, so you can close out of this screen. Zigbee to MQTT, Zigbee to MQTT Edge, and Zigbee to MQTT Proxy should now appear. If not, refresh your screen or press PF5 on a Windows machine to make the add-ons appear. Now select Zigbee to MQTT, which is the first entry. Press install. Now turn on Watchdog and show in sidebar and press start. To make sure that everything is working, press the log in the top menu. You should see an entry saying onboard page is available at http://0.0.0.0:8099. This means it is in the configuration system ready to use. Press the info tab on the top menu. Now press the open web UI on the right hand side. These are web pages that allow for the ultimate in easy installation. The first field for found devices allows for easy configuration of USB devices. So if you connected the MR1 by USB, you'll be able to find it here. But since we've connected the MR1 over the network, we need an IP or TCP/IP address. To obtain this, switch back to your MR1 dashboard. Navigate to the Z2M or ZHA in the left-hand menus. For Radio 2, which is the right column, make sure it's in Zigbee 2MQTT is selected. Copy the command after the port on the sixth line, which should start with TCP. Now switch back to Home Assistant and paste the command into the coordinator adapter port path field. Next, we need the stack, of which there are five different options. If we switch back to the MR1 dashboard, here you can see that we need to use the Z stack. Select this from the dropdown. The next options for network channel and generate key, network PAN ID and network extended PAN ID can all be left as generate. The MQTT base topic and server should be left as default. The MQTT user and password can be left as they will be set based on the system level authentication and not related to the ones we entered into the configuration. All the remaining fields can be left as default unless you wish to fine-tune your setup, in which case, press the hyperlink below the field for more details as to what these features do and can be set up as. Scroll to the bottom and press submit. Now press the back arrow and you should be dropped into the Zigbee to MQTT dashboard page. You can now pair Zigbee to MQTT devices as you normally would. The SMLight SLZB-MR1 is one of the most capable and forward-thinking coordinators I've tested. It's not the cheapest option, and it's bigger than the standard USB stick, but the performance, flexibility, and future-proofing it offers makes it a seriously strong choice for anyone who wants to run both Zigbee with either ZHA or Zigbee to MQTT, or mix it up a little bit with Thread border routers in their home, all from one coordinator. If you're looking for an upgrade to your coordinator, or you're planning on a new build that's Matter ready from day one, this is definitely worth a look. And since filming this video, SMLight have taken this to the next level, providing the MR2, a Thread and Zigbee Pro adapter, the MR3, a flagship 3SOC zero compromise adapter, or the MR4, peak performance and full potential coordinator. These have some of the most powerful SoCs and amplifiers and dB gain antennas on the market, so they have an adapter for you, whatever your level of expertise. Links to the full range in the description below. Well, I hope you enjoyed the video, and if you did, then hit that like button, comment and share. And if you want to have access to similar material, then maybe subscribe or maybe become a channel member and get early access to material plus other perks. And if you want to join other like-minded people, then why not join the Discord channel where smart home enthusiasts meet to solve each other's issues. And if I've helped you make a purchasing decision, then maybe a super thanks or a PayPal donation. It's really appreciated. Until the next one.